Alright, my theory's been debunked. Although I'm secretly hoping that this isn't actually true, until we get a picture of Chris. I mean, I know he can be... Sorry, that's my dog. Are you right? He's not right. He's very amped up because I was at the office all day today, where usually I work from home. So he's been on his own, and now he's got the zoomies. Anyway, that wasn't the point of this video.
Do you have your moose? Do you have Moosey? What are you doing? What are you doing? What are you doing?
Alright, I should end this video because I should go play with him. But yes, anyway, so yeah, this theory has seemingly been debunked. But yeah, I really appreciated all the comments on that video. But there was one comment I wanted to address really quickly, which was... A couple of people were talking about how, yeah, historically shows are filmed chronologically, so they're filmed in order, like, you know, episode one, episode two, whatever. But I was like, actually, and I think most of the time that is true, but with The Samurai Turned Pretty, it's not always true, because Jenny herself told us that they shot two very significant scenes that were episodes apart on the same night. So I just think that's interesting. So they all, you know, depending on, like, time and location and all that kind of stuff. Oh, are you playing with Moose? He's chewing on a moose. Anyway, and I'll just so include that clip, because I just think that's, you know, interesting information to know that that's how they shoot certain things. And also it kind of showcases the actors, especially in this instance, the actors' ability to turn certain emotions on and off, and to bring their whole selves to certain scenes. And it's certainly, yeah, the case for Chris and Lola in these two scenes too. Anyway, the lighting is so bad, but yeah, I'll just include that clip. So yeah, people might already know this, but yeah, they shot this very cutesy scene, which is an episode, it's a flashback in episode one? No, it's episode two or three. Yeah, the beach scene before, you know, they sleep together for the first time. It's all very cute. But then they also shot this scene from the party in episode six, where it was very intense. So it's just interesting. Interesting to know that. Anyway.
I'm literally, like, falling asleep, but I might be able to explain this really quickly. I'm gonna try to make this video short, and I'll go more in depth later, but I have just explained this so many times. He cheated on Belly, period. Like, in the book, when she finds out that he, like, fucked Lacey, she literally says, "You cheated on me." And he does not disagree, which means that he knew what the fuck he did was cheating, period. No matter how you look at it, they were together for 2 years. They were broken up for about maybe 2 to 3 days before he fucked Lacey. And then he came back with a bracelet and didn't tell her. Cheating is the fact, like, the cheating is mostly the fact that he didn't tell her, because if he genuinely didn't think that he did anything wrong because they were on a break, then he would have just said something and then apologized with the fucking ring that he didn't even buy. It's just pathetic. He cheated on her. Literally every single time that somebody mentions, "He cheated on you, I cheat," like, things like that, like, nobody denies it because they know that it is cheating, period. And the fact that, like, bro literally introduced her to Lacey knowing that he fucked her is even weirder. It's about loyalty. It's about, like, faithfulness. It's not about whether or not they were officially together. I don't care what anybody else says. And I can't really go into depth because it's, like, late and I am tired of shit. But it's cheating, period. And I've explained this so many times. I'm not gonna, like, bro, like, I just don't understand how I can, like, make anybody else, like, get it. But it was cheating, period. And I have quotes from the book to, like, just, like, back up my point, if you would like it. Just wanna let this story die, and I'll be alright. We can't be friends, but I'd like to just pretend. You cling to your papers and pens. Wait until you like me.
What I said earlier, I didn't mean it. I still want you. Of course I do.